Hello my lovely kids. Good morning to all. Hope you all are fine and studying regularly. Welcome back in my GK class. Students, in our previous lessons, we had learned about the great inventions, how to read time in a clock, different types of animals, and their characteristics. Right? So kids, today we will increase our GK knowledge more by learning the states and famous cities in India. We will see it from these two lessons, Map of India and Cities to Visit. Children, India is a democratic republic country and New Delhi is its capital. India's official languages are Hindi and English. India is recognized by 23 languages that people speak in various states. India has 28 states and 8 union territories. Every state has its own capital and some speciality. Union territory is not like state. State has their own government. But union territories are directly ruled by the central government. Therefore, it reflects the name Union Territory. Students, see, this is the map of India. Now, we will fill the states and union territories in it. Are you ready for that? Okay. So, let us start to fill the states in the map from north side. Jammu and Kashmir is the first one. Children, Jammu and Kashmir was one of the states of India as per our workbook. But now Jammu and Kashmir is divided into two regions, that is Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh, on 31st October 2019. These two are now administered as Union Territories by India. So, the first state is Himachal Pradesh. Capital is Shimla in the summer and Dharamshala in the winter. Next, Punjab. Capital is Chandigarh. Haryana. Capital is Chandigarh. Means both state capital is same. Next, Uttarakhand. Capital is Dehradun. Uttar Pradesh, capital is Lucknow. Next state, Rajasthan, capital is Jaipur. Children, Rajasthan is the largest state in India. Then, Madhya Pradesh, capital is Bhopal. Bihar, capital is Patna. Now children, we will see the east side map of India. Okay? First we see the state Sikkim. Sikkim capital is Gangtok. Kids, the highest peak of India, Kanchenjunga, is situated in this state. Then next state, West Bengal. Capital is Kolkata. Meghalaya. Capital is Shillong. Assam. Capital is Dispur. Then Arunachal Pradesh. Capital is Itanagar. Students, this state is known as the land of the rising sun. Next, Nagaland. Capital is Koima. Then Manipur, capital is Imphal. Tripura. Capital is Agartala. Mizoram. Capital is Aizawl. Children, Mizoram is also called as the land of blue mountains. Then Jharkhand. Capital is Ranchi. Odisha. Capital is Bhubaneswar. Kids, this state is well known for Sun Temple at Konark. Next state, Chhattisgarh. Capital is Raipur. Kids, now we will move to west side map of India. Firstly, we see the state Gujarat. Gujarat capital is Gandhinagar. Next state, Maharashtra. The capital is Mumbai in the summer and Nagpur in the winter. Students, do you know? Mumbai is also the commercial capital of India. Then Goa. Capital is Panji. Telangana. Capital is Hyderabad. Now kids, we will see the south side map of India. Okay? The state Karnataka. Capital is Bengaluru. Andhra Pradesh. Capital is Amravati. Kerala. Capital is Thiruvananthapuram. And the last state, Tamil Nadu. Capital is Chennai. Children, now we have learned 28 states and their capitals. Kids, along with 28 states, there are 8 union territories. Kids, now we will see these 8 union territories here. First, Andaman and Nicobar Islands. The capital is Port Blair. Second, Chandigarh. The capital of Chandigarh is itself only. Third, Dadra and Nagar Haveli. And Daman and Diu. Both union territories have become a single union territory since 26 January 2020. And the capital of it is Daman. Fourth, Lakshadweep. Capital is Kavaratti. Fifth, National Capital Territory, Delhi. And the capital is Delhi itself. Sixth, Puducherry or Pondicherry. And the capital is Puducherry itself. Seventh, Ladakh. Capital is Leh Kargil. And the 8th Union Territory, Jammu and Kashmir. Capital is Srinagar in the summer and Jammu in the winter. Children, hope you understood the states and union territories in the map of India. Correct? Okay. Kids, India is a beautiful country with each city having its own speciality. Now, we will see the places in the same cities that one should definitely visit. Students, first we visit to Kolkata city. Kolkata city is in the state of West Bengal. This city is well known for its dance forms and sweets. The National Library is situated in this city. Second city, Chennai. Chennai is a city in the state of Tamil Nadu. This city is known for its music, art and culture. It is also famous for its automobile industry. Due to that, this city is known as Detroit of India. Next cities, Varanasi and Agra. Both cities are located in the state of Uttar Pradesh. Varanasi is situated at the banks of the Ganga River. It is famous for its temples, Buddhism and yoga. Kids, Agra has the Taj Mahal. Taj Mahal is one of the seven wonders of the world. It is the symbol of love. One more city, Jaipur. Jaipur city is in the state of Rajasthan. This city is known as the Pink City of India and is famous for its forts and monuments. Next famous cities, Mumbai and Pune. Both are in the state of Maharashtra. Children, do you know? Mumbai is known as the city which never sleeps. And Pune is known as the city of education. It is also famous for the Ganesh temple. Kids, now New Delhi. This city is the capital of India. All political headquarters are in this city. Students, next Hyderabad. This city is in the state of Telangana and it is known for jewels. Also, the Ramoji Film City, that is world's largest film studio complex, is located here. Children, one more city, Bengaluru. This city is in the state of Karnataka. Bengaluru is called the Silicon Valley of India. Students, Manali is one of the famous city in the state of Himachal Pradesh. It is a famous hill station. It is also famous as a backpacking center. Hey kids, Darjeeling is one more famous city in the state of West Bengal. Darjeeling is famous for its black tea and Himalayan Railway. Children, India's each and every city having its own speciality. Today, we have seen some of them here. Students, hope you enjoyed these two lessons and also learned something new and most important. Right? So, try to fill the states and union territories in the map of India. Okay? Thank you so much, my lovely kiddos. Take care of yourself. Bye-bye.
Hello, my cutie pies. A lovely good morning to all. Hope you all are fine and doing your studies regularly. Yes? Fantastic. Welcome back in our GK class with a new lesson. Students, today we live in an independent country. There were many freedom fighters who fought for the freedom of India. Because of them, we are celebrating Independence Day. I salute the real heroes who gave us freedom. The list of freedom fighters is endless. Children, do you know any freedom fighters? Yes, very good. So, Today we are going to learn lesson number 18, Who Am I? I will show you images of freedom fighters along with some information. Okay? Let's see. Children, here is the first picture of our great leader Sarojini Naidu. She is known as Nightingale of India, a poet and a great politician. At an early age, she went to London for further studies. She became the first woman governor of India. She was remembered as a great leader. Students, next picture is of our great leader Bal Gangadhar Tilak. He was a journalist, teacher, social reformer and lawyer. He is better known for his quote, Swaraj Mera Janamsit Adhikar Hai Aur Main Ise Lekar Rahunga. Swaraj is my birthright and I shall have it. He started Ganesh Chaturthi festival as a public festival in Maharashtra. Children, next picture of our national hero is Subhash Chandra Bose. He was an Indian freedom fighter. He is known as Netaji. He was the president of Indian National Congress. His famous slogan was, Tum mujhe khoon do, main tumhe azadi dunga. Give me blood and I will give you freedom. Now, next picture of great leader is Annie Besant. During her presidency, she became actively involved in the Indian struggle for independence. She was elected the first woman president of the Indian National Congress. Students, now we are going to learn some extra national heroes which are not mentioned in our workbook. Here, picture of national hero is Shaheed Bhagat Singh. He was born in Punjab to a Sikh family deeply involved in political activities. He quit school at the age of 13 to devote his life to Indian independence. He died at a very young age of 23. Inqilab Zindabad. The meaning of this slogan is the long life. The revolution, by speaking this slogan, everyone motivates himself. Now, next picture of our national hero is Ram Prasad Bismil. He was one of the most talented patriotic writer of the time. Sarfaroshi ki tamanna ab hamare dil mein hai, dekhna hai zor kitna bazu-e qatil mein hai. These lines are taken from his patriotic poem, which was later used as a slogan to challenge the British authority ruling in India. Next picture of national hero is Chandrasekhar Azad. He was one of the popular freedom fighter who fought for Indian independence movement. He was a Sanskrit scholar and went to further study in Banaras. He was an active member of the Hindu Republican Association. The slogan he gave, Ab bhi jiska khoon nahi khola, khoon nahi wo paani hai, jo desh ke kaam na aaye, wo bekar jawani hai. He led the spirit to fight for the freedom of the country. Students, we live in an independent country because of our real heroes. It's our right to enjoy the freedom, but never forget the sacrifices of freedom fighters. India is independent because of our forefathers. Now, it's our responsibility to maintain its freedom in future too. Students, there are many national heroes. Today we have seen some of them here. Hope you liked to see and enjoyed it. Try to collect more information about our national leaders. Students, complete your notes and do practice of reading and writing. Now, it's time to leave. See you soon. Till then, thank you. Goodbye. Take care. Love you all. Have a great day.